वेलकम टू मूवीज अट एंड दिस इज योर बॉलीवुड गाइड G9 यानी कि दिव्य सोलगामा इन कॉन्वर्सेशन विद टैलेंटेड एक्टर अभिषेक बच्चन. अभिषेक, फर्स्ट थिंग्स फर्स्ट, काइंडली शेयर विद अस द बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स यू गॉट ओवर द प्रोमो ऑफ योर अपकमिंग फिल्म ऑल इज वेल.
चिंटो अंकल, आई रिमेंबर वी वर शूटिंग दिस सॉन्ग कॉल्ड नचा फराटे एंड द ट्रेलर उमेश शोड चिंटो अंकल द ट्रेलर. चिंटो अंकल, यार ट्रेलर, योर ट्रेलर इज वेरी नाइस. आई सेड चिंटो अंकल, वी मेड द होल फिल्म टुगेदर, यू आर टेलिंग मी. नहीं यार, आई रियली लाइक्ड इट. सो व्हेन चिंटो अंकल एन एक्टर द कैलिबर ऑफ मिस्टर ऋषि कपूर सेज दैट द ट्रेलर इज नाइस, समथिंग हैज टू बी राइट. आई लाइक्ड इट, इट टच्ड मी समवेयर एंड आई थिंक इट कन्वेज व्हाट द फिल्म इज अबाउट. सो फार आई थिंक द रिस्पॉन्स हैज बीन वेरी ऑनेस्टली बेटर देन व्हाट आई एक्सपेक्टेड. But at the end of the day, the film will talk and do what it has to do. And people generally give you feedback once they see the film. I think a trailer of 2.5 minutes is too short to form an opinion. But the purpose of a trailer is to entice. And I think the trailer of All Is Well has done that successfully. And it's a nice trailer. I like it. It was sweet.
Abhishek, in your film All Is Well, you are working with senior actors like Rishi Kapoor and Supriya Pathak. So how was the working experience with them? And as a student of cinema, what did you learn from these talented actors?
Supriya ji and I have done, this is our fourth film together. I call her my Nirupa Roy. She's always playing my mother. I love working with her. I think there's a quiet dignity about her performance style, which is very unique. I think she has a very challenging role in this movie because she's playing an Alzheimer's patient and she has very few dialogues. And for an actor, the most difficult thing is to convey emotion without any crutches or any action or any dialogue. And to convey that purely by your performance is very difficult. And she does it so beautifully in such a dignified manner. So, a lot of respect for that. How much time do you have? Because I can talk about Chintu Uncle all night. You know, I've always said that, you know, after my dad, if there's somebody whose fan I've been, it's been him. I had the honor and opportunity to work with him in Dilli Che. But that was a much smaller role. And I was always looking for that opportunity to do a full-length film with him. And when Umesh told me that, you know, he wanted to take Chintu Uncle in this film, I was overjoyed. Because like you said, just being in the frame with him, your performance will improve. He's that good, you know. And but my favorite thing about him is his you know, he has a childlike enthusiasm towards his work, which is brilliant. You know, I mean, he was telling me yesterday he's been working for over 45 years, and still, you know, he comes on the set and there's this exuberance, you know, this surge of energy, saying, "Yeah, let's make a film," and you know, it's fantastic. It's fantastic.
Abhishek, Rishi Kapoor is known for his humor and you are also known for your pranks at the sets. So how was the fun element at the shooting time of All Is Well?
I don't know how much time you spent on an actual film set, but if you ever get that opportunity, you'll see majority of actors love to have fun when they're working. You know, and you know, people unfortunately keep saying that, oh, you're a prankster, this, that. I'm not. You know, a prankster is somebody who plays pranks. I don't play pranks. I like to have fun. Because, you know, you make a film, you spend average 6 to 8 months. Day in, day out, you're the same people, you're doing the same work, you know. You have to look forward to it. You have to enjoy it. I mean, you have to enjoy doing what you do to come back to it and do it every day. But you have to love doing what you do and you have to make it fun. You see, 99.9% of movie sets are full of fun. People are having a lot of fun because they have to enjoy what they do. Because filmmaking is a very serious business. Even comedy is very serious business. What we do, we take very seriously. So when that camera is rolling, it's, you know, blinkers on, let's go for it. But you have to make that process a lot of fun. It's important. So obviously, if you have somebody like Chintu Uncle, you know, your set is going to be full of joy, as it should be.
Abhishek, All Is Well is said to be a story of a modern-day Shravan Kumar. And we all know the love and respect you have for your parents and have seen Mr. Amitabh Bachchan also doing the same for his parents. So in the times of modernization, where the Indian principles and values are diluting, how easy or tough was it for you to get inside the skin of your character? And also share with us your personal reason to do this film.
I'm glad you asked that. You know, I've always thought it's very important when you're promoting a film, and we never get asked this, why did you do the film? What is the reason, personal reason behind an actor choosing a film? We never get asked that. And I think that's the most important question to ask. This film deals with certain principles, morals and values which are Indian, which I feel sadly we're losing in today's day and age. See, I'm all for modernity, okay? There has to be progress. I'm completely for that. But we should not trade in our values just to progress. See, I always say this one thing that, which really struck home, you know, we were shooting in Shimla One night we were all having dinner in Chintu Uncle's room. We were talking about the film and what the film talks about and Umesh's reason for making the film. He said, when was the last time when you went home late at night after finishing work late? You went and checked on your parents. He said, did you ever go to their room? Wake them up, have you eaten? He says, jabhi bhi aap ghar chhod ke bahar nikle, aapki maa aapse puche, beta, khana theek se khana. Have you ever called your mother and said, have you eaten your food? You don't do it. Think about it, man. Because when he asked me this, I felt so bad. And I feel I'm a pretty good son, you know. I do what I do for my family. Woh mujhe laga yaar ki, haan yaar. My dad till date, I'm married, I have a child. If I'm going out for dinner, he says, don't be too late. Doesn't mean it. It's just out of love. I can come back at 12 the next afternoon. But he'll say it. But when I'm out at dinner, do I call home and say, have you gone to sleep? Papa so gaye? Theek se na? Do we do that? Why? Have you thought about that? And that's what this film is dealing with. That we, in today's day and age, have got so busy with our own selfish needs. Not in a wrong way, but that's just the way society is today. We forget some of the important things. We work day and night for what? For our families, right? But the one thing we're compromising in this journey is our family. It deals with a generation gap. And it's both sided. Huh? It's not just from a son's point of view. I mean, I start the film as a very selfish son. And he realizes all the sacrifices my parents have made for me, which I never even considered. I didn't even think about it. That's how in self-absorbed I was. And also from a father's point of view. That, yeah, maybe what I want for my child is not what my child wants for themselves. It's a very good dialogue in Chintungal. That it's not necessary that a son becomes a doctor ka beta doctor bane, aur ek engineer ka beta engineer. I thought these are such very nice topics to talk about. And what I loved about Umesh is he says it in a very entertaining way. If you see, oh my god, it's such a serious topic he's taken. But you know, he hasi mazak mein usko saja ke tells the story, which I think is so nice. And even in this, we see the promo, the banter, this, that. But slowly, in the climax, when you realize, hey, wait, yeah. And I say, my God, my parents have actually done so much for me, but I had such, you know, blinders on that I did not even consider ki mere pitaji ne mere liye kya kya kiya hai. I never considered it also. I thought that was a very important thing to talk about. So, you know, unfortunately, what happens when you discuss something like this about the film, suddenly people say, yeah, it's very serious, yeah, should not be boring. But what's nice is that I think Umesh has cracked that code where he says it in such an entertaining way. So I hope people, when they see the film, they come out and they question themselves. I want them to feel bad. When I heard the story, I felt very bad. I said, yeah, am I a good son? Well, I hope the audience comes out feeling bad. And like Umesh said, I hope families go in. And I hope they come out as better families. I think that's a very noble thing to do. So I hope it works.
Abhishek, your last two films were comical and multi-starrer ones. And even after All Is Well, the next two films are also same. So why this sudden inclination towards the multi-starrer comical films? Don't you feel by doing so, it will tarnish your image of an intense actor who is known for his roles in Guru, Yuva, Sarkar, Dam Maro Dam and other films?
It's a matter of choice, Divya. It's not... I started my career with Refugee, right? My next film was Tera Jadoo Chaliya. My next film was Dhaayak Supreme. Then I did Bas Itna Sa Khwab Hai. I've always endeavored to do something that has challenged me. For me as an actor, it's important that I'm challenged all the time. Otherwise, I'll get bored with my work. Even if I do the same thing. Somebody asked me, oh, your last few films have only been comedies. I said, no, I did Bol Bachchan. Then I did Dhoom, which was completely opposite. After Dhoom, I did Happy New Year, which again was different. Now I'm doing All Is Well, which is not a comedy. It's more of a family film. It's an emotional film. Then I go back into a comedy. Maybe I'm enjoying it right now. You know, when I started doing these comedies again, I think a designed comedy. Some of my films unknowingly become comedies. Mm-hmm. But I think the last one before Bol Bachchan I did was, I think, Dostana. And then I did a good 5 years of more serious films. I think an actor goes through phases. So I'd come off a spate of some very intense films. You know, Pa was a very intense film for me. Khele Hum Ji Jaan Se was a very intense film for me. Dam Maro Dam was very intense. These are intense emotional films. At that point, I just felt like I wanted to do something lighthearted. So I took on like a Bol Bachchan and, you know. So I think that you go through that phase and then again you say, okay, now I feel like doing something like this. The good thing is if you're an actor who is blessed enough to get a job, then you can choose that job based on what you're feeling. Like I feel once I finish this lot of my comedies, now I'm ready to do something a bit more introverted. Maybe I'm over that phase where I want to just let it all out. Maybe now I want to introvert a bit. You know, I'm feeling that right now. So maybe my next couple of films will be somewhere reflecting that. I don't know. Again, it just depends. You can hear a script. I mean, I was in the middle of Happy New Year and I was in the middle of actually shooting Bol Bachchan when Umesh narrated All Is Well. I said, yeah, I like the story. Father-son relationship, emotional. I want to be part of this. But at that point, I'm going on set and playing Abbas Ali and Abhishek Bachchan in Bol. Bachchan, and then carrying on with Happy New Year, Nandu Bhide. So it just depends. A story can inspire you like that. So it's literally that momentary instinctive reaction that you have to that script. I keep getting asked this question, which kind of bores me, which is, oh sir, you're doing a solo hero film after a long time. So now I'm going to stop answering that question, because people are not wanting to understand what I'm saying. You know, no matter how many times I tell you all that, you know, what is a solo hero, they don't want to. They still keep answering that. You know, no, you've been doing multi-star cast films. Yeah, I like the kahani. I want to be part of it. I want to be happy when I'm acting, you know. Simple as that. So I choose a film not based on how many actors there are. I choose the thing, okay, I like the story, I like my role, I'm going to do it. It's literally that simple process for me. Farah spoke to me about Happy New Year before even she told me that she was considering Shah Rukh in this. I knew about it after Om Shanti Om. She's had the script for 10 years. And then only she had told me about Nandu Bhide. So it's not about who you're working with. You know, we're blessed today that you get fantastic actors and people who are on the film. But you do a film because you want to do it, yeah? It makes you happy, right? If I'm going to do a film because this is the right kind of film, then I'll be miserable making it. It's going to show on camera, you'll be miserable watching it. That's simple as that. You know, a movie like Bol Bachchan, if I'm going to be miserable and just say, oh, Rohit Shetty, Ajay Devgan, super hit jodi, inke saath picture banayenge, toh bhaiya, nikal padegi hum logon ki, but I'm depressed doing that film. I'll never be able to do the stuff that I did in that film. You know, the camera doesn't lie. And nobody's such a good actor that they can hide from the camera. So that's been my process, always. And I hope I'm never in a situation where I need to change that. It'll be a very sad day for me, you know. So I do the films that I enjoy doing, you know, or I want to do. You can't do films for strategic reasons.
Coming back to the great films like Guru, You Are Sarkaar, and also huge hits like Bol Bachchan, Dhoom, Dostana, Bluffmaster and others. Which among these films was your dream role?
You beat films for baat kar, but you should never, as an actor, feel live in your past. You have done your work, then do it. You should do better work. You should be on that mission. I cannot rest on my laurels. Agar aap logon ko Guru aur Bol Bachchan bahut pasand hai, thank you. Mehnat ki thi sab logon ne film ke upar, it did well, thank you. But if I'm going to say, pata hai, maine Guru film banayi thi, kab banayi thi bhai? 7-8 saal ho gaye, abhi aaj kya kar rahe ho? People live for today, don't live for yesterday, never look back. I said it in an interview the other day, you know, many years ago, jab hum log struggler the, main yahi bagal mein mere ek mitra hain, Uday Chopra, unka ghar hai. To Adi, unke jo bade bhai hain, unke saath संडेज को हम लोग क्रिकेट खेलते थे उनके गार्डन में. तो एक दिन शाहरुख भी आए थे वहाँ, तो उनसे बात कर रहे थे उदय, मैं, आदि, शाहरुख. मैंने कहा कि शाहरुख, व्हाट इज योर ड्रीम रोल? तो ही टॉट मी समथिंग व्हिच आई हैव ऑलवेज केप्ट वेरी क्लोज टू माय हार्ट. आई थिंक इज ब्रिलियंट. ही सेड, यू नो द फिल्म यू आर डूइंग एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, दैट शुड बी योर ड्रीम रोल. क्योंकि अगर वो तुम्हारा ड्रीम रोल नहीं है, यू विल नेवर डू 100% फॉर इट. सो योर ड्रीम रोल शुड ऑलवेज बी द फिल्म यू आर डूइंग एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम.
Abhishek, many upcoming filmmakers feel that the songs and dances or the lip-sync songs dilute the intensity of a film. What's your take on this whole matter?
Our culture is musical. Indian storytelling, our heritage of storytelling, our legacy of storytelling is musical. Even our scriptures are sung. Throughout mythology, throughout all our civilizations, we have a history of telling our stories through song. If you read the Ramayana and the Gita, it's all in to a tune. So our storytelling history is musical. That is the main reason why we have, if you put songs in this kind of situations like we have in a Hollywood film, they won't understand anything. Ki kya hai? Wo samajh mein nahi aata. Musical they'll understand. They don't understand. For us, it's very normal. I think it's perfectly normal. In fact, that's one of my favorite parts of Hindi films. You know, that's what makes us unique. So I don't think it jars at all. No, think about it, you know. Today's generation, obviously lesser, because it's not done with as much fervor. You're making a film, Mumbai, on the street, this, that. Boy looks at girl looks at boy. They come very close, they're about to kiss. Cut to close-up of two flowers doing this. Cut to Switzerland and you're singing a song. How cool is that? You know? Come on, that's the wonder of cinema. You don't question it. You just go with it. It's great. I love it. Like when I see a lot of my friends from abroad who see my, that's what they love the most about it. They're like, this is super cool. You know? So I love it.
Abhishek, many of your fans want to see you working back with Aishwarya. So when do we see you guys back on the silver screen? And what's your take on her upcoming film, Jazba?
See, this is a question no actor can answer. You know, we would love to do whatever we want to do, but it's not in our hands. Somebody has to write a good script. Somebody has to, have, you know, direct a film. There are many other factors that need to come into it. I'd love to do a film with her, but, you know, all of these pieces have to fall into place first. Well, I've seen some snippets here and there. It's been very nice. It's a very emotional, so it's a very intense film. It's a mold we've not seen her in before. So I'm very excited for that. Yeah, it should be a lot of fun.
Abhishek, as you mentioned that you are a film lover and love to watch films. So which was the last film you saw and what's next in your playlist?
The last Hindi film I saw was Dil Dhadakne Do, and I really enjoyed it. I want to see these last few, I was with Ajay Devgn yesterday, so I'm going to see Drishyam one of these days. I believe it's very good. I'm dying to see Bajrangi Bhaijaan because it's meant to be a superb film. Bahubali, yeah. My friends made it, so yeah. I've been so busy with my kabaddi team that I've just had no time. I can't find that 3 hours to sit down. And for me, watching a movie is like religion. I don't like to be disturbed. I like mobiles off. Nobody should talk. There's that complete silence, bowl of popcorn and samosa and go, you know. It should be like that. I love it. I love going to the cinema. There's no greater joy for me and my family to go to the movies. So it's great fun.
Lastly, Abhishek, what's happening over Bluffmaster 2?
We've been trying to make Bluffmaster happen for a long time, but obviously, you know, we need the right script. Part 1 had become such a cultish kind of a film. You have to live up to it. So, the only thing I can say is we're working towards something. We haven't cracked anything yet. So the intention is there. We'd love to do it. Ritesh, myself and Rohan are all on board. So the intention is there. We have to obviously crack the right thing, but we're working towards it, and I hope it happens. Yeah.